Hello, welcome to a Halloween theme game. Okay, let's press E. It's kind of late in the day, so I was worried we will not have enough time to speak with her. Memory powder. Oh, eh. Also, I want to see how much we actually unlocked. Did we unlock all of... Yeah, we unlocked everything. So, protection potions, berserk potions, restoring potions. We have unlocked everything, and you can also buy a lot of alchemical supplies for her from her as well. They're a bit expensive if you ask me, so be very careful what you buy. But you'll probably want all of the speed potions you can take, even though they are 1 silver. We still have the frogs? Really? You can study the frog? I didn't think about that. And also, of course, the apples and the berry seedlings. Alchemy recipe, what? Why do they have... I will check that later. Let's ask about the Ash of the Witch. Have you come to visit your old friend? Yes, my deluded old friend who basically destroyed the world. Could you... Well, she was sane at the time. Could you please do me a favor? I need some witch ashes for my alchemy experience. Could you give me some? I don't have much of it nowadays. It's not as easy to collect as it used to. How did you collect it then? I can spare a little. A couple of jars of honey. Well, why? Sweet home, I think I have some honey in here, but I don't have time to go back. Why do I have a vampire's jaw? Oh, violet pen. So I guess you can buy the recipes from her and you'll get the random paints that you can use to decorate your room and some other stuff. Use equip now. Well, I used to have a lot of funny, but I guess I used it for some other stuff. Anyway, it's kind of late to go back to Clotho, so let's go... let's go and collect honey in the middle of the night, while zombies are walking by. Also, this is the time you can get moss as well. Eh, let's just collect all the honey, because, you know, I'm efficient, and that's the only reason I have gotten so far into the game. Whenever I do something, I completely do it. I was not meant to do the flower. Well, I guess we can plant some flowers in our house. Again, that's for later. Probably I'll still work after I finish the DLC. I'll still work on the house and making it pretty. Make a video with the review for all of the DLCs. And then maybe, you know, start the game from zero. That will be terrifying starting from zero. Especially because now you have millions of things to do. It's not like before you had to do only one thing. Chop wood and mine iron. No, no. Okay, get out of the way of the zombie. They are not really... They can't see very well. They're kind of old and decrepit. If I remember correctly, Clotho goes to bed kind of late. But she also comes out of her house kind of late of else. Kind of late as well. Also, well, I guess I should do something about my problems with the storage. But I'm a bit too lazy to solve it right now. Oh man, and I didn't put my shelves up. Burning witch. Oh, we don't have a soul receiver in here either. Yeah, well, that will be for another episode. For now, let's focus on the task at hand. It's so nice to have these speed potions. It's like the game is on easy mode right now. I mean, the game was never hard. People complained that it was too grindy, but it's not really that grindy. You just have to be very well prepared and organized. I think if you want to finish the game from start to zero, you only need a... Well, actually with all the DLC it might take a longer time. Or with the DLC it might take less time than before. Yeah, exactly. She's not out yet. Okay, we just caught her. Ooh, honey. Something delicious recently. And I just can't go to the village. How do you collect the witch's ashes? Every woman has her secrets. Okay, here, take some ash. Unusual ash. Well, can I use it to make burgers? A bit of heresy for the Inquisitor. And this is when things get very convoluted. Because now I have to go over here. Oh, the, well, it's not going to be a very long time before the Inquisitors come, but I just waste another speed potion because of it. I don't have to walk. Well, it looks like my baking days are still ahead of me. Let's actually destroy... no. Destroy the berries. And let's put the honey in there. I'm pretty sure we'll need it later. No, no. I cannot risk damaging my, you know, my... order. So let's put everything in here, including the beeswax. Keeper's key. Why do I have the keeper's key? Don't remember a thing. And now this is where the fun part of the game begins. We're just going to meditate on how bad we're doing right now. Come on, I hope that I really hope the developers will just put a calendar. So you press one button, you press the calendar, and then you magically wake up in that day, because this is super annoying. It can take so long until you reach the day you want, especially if you're playing the game again, or if you're just waiting for a single day to happen. I don't think we have another quest right now. We just have to wait until we get the Pride one, or what was it? No, not Pride. Wrath, until we get the Angry one. Angry Sin, and then we'll get access to the next one, so... just waiting. And we are looking at the time ticking down. Sorry about this. I'm just collecting my thoughts while I'm waiting for this one. So... we'll basically need to use our other characters. So if you're playing this game again, you'll basically be doing this quest in parallel. So, for example, you might want to see the Inquisitor for a quest, but you also might have this quest. Not sure when you get the quest for this one. For this DLC to begin. So yeah, you might have to do many quests at the same time. Besides, I think each iteration of the DLC will bring you a series of quests with the characters. Hey, leave that. Let's go to our burger stand. We haven't visited our burger stand in a very, very long time. By the way, that's the house of Snake and the Inquisitor, if I remember correctly. Wait, the Inquisitor is not here. What day was he supposed to arrive here? Oh yeah, he should be here. I don't feel like walking today. What? The guards arrived before the Inquisitor? Yeah, we had fun selling beers and burgers. I just like how the map slowly changes as you build more stuff and as you progress into the game. That's one of my favorite things. I mean, we have the refugee camp, we have the camp up north where we get the resources with our zombies. We have the tavern and some other things as well. Okay, let's prepare for something funny. Show ash. Also, we need a shard of sin to load the to the specific sin. Take a look at this. What's this? Understand that your corpse says, and you may do whatever you like with them. But you shouldn't be bothering me with that sort of thing. I'm not here to bother your excellency. Here, take a look. And what is this? It's witch ash. They use it in their occult rites. The handkerchief smells like an old witch. Sniff it for yourself. Ew. Well, it does smell like an old witch. Indeed. Does this mean that I burn witches, purge the world of their unholy power, and they perform heresy with my own aid? Oh, he got so mad over there. What am I doing? No one has... So Keeper, I hope that you're intelligent enough to see that this kind of information was the main top secret. Its disclosure is punishable by death. As usual, no one will know. That's actually very funny if you put it that way. I mean, the way he's burning the witches, it actually creates raw materials for other witches to perform even more sinister rituals. Well, I would be angry too if I knew that. Oh, again, I forgot to use my teleporter, but it's almost as fast as to walk. This is the pride charged one. This is the wrath charged one, okay. Yurik, it's time for your your next ancient Chinese medicine therapy session. Oh, I forgot to go through the morgue. It's so long if you take the road from here. I mean, my house is basically like a maze or a big castle at this point. Yep. Actually, let's extract the souls from this one. It's quite fresh. Nobody. The body is here. People say that if you put it in the level 3 one, the soul will not decay, but I think it still decays a little bit, even if it's in the tier 3 one. I forgot about that sound effect. Okay, enough fun. Let's do the quest. Gluttony? One person eats for two. Maybe I should go to the merchant and try my luck. But we know how to get him food. It's a challenge because he has such high standards. You will need an unusual approach. Perhaps we should not focus on the food itself, but on something that can be served with food. What do you mean? Like a sauce served with a dish. Something that will be slight. I know one alchemy master, I'll talk to him. Oh, come on, I have to go to Kloto again, but I... Hey, and also, I'm an alchemy master myself. No, contain yourself, we have no time to to process the fresh body, it's so fresh. I mean, it's so fresh, it still smells of life. Okay, let's just go over here. I mean, we do have the potion for enhancement or something. Anyway, she probably knows how to make it better. Hey, back again, handsome. You're finally ready for that date? No. Nothing would make me happier, but I have so much to do. Can we do it later? I'm just joking, so what can this... Well, you can prepare potions and that's kind of it. Are getting to know me better? Okay, what you do? Enhances the taste of a dish. Gastronomic question. What? Oh. There you go. There is indeed such a recipe and it contains simple ingredients. Oh, note from... She has such a nice voice, even if she's not really making sense. I think you're supposed to get random recipes with the alchemy one. She also restocked the speed potions. Oh, she didn't have max. Okay. Wait, did she give me a... What did she give me? Make the sauce for the merchant on the church workbench. Okay, this time I remember to teleport. The church workbench. The church workbench is in the church? Okay, that's weird. Okay, church workbench. I don't suppose it's on the back section. Okay, seed oil. Chicken egg. I think I can buy the chicken at any time. Have the salt, chicken egg, and seed oil. Yeah, that's basically mayonnaise. Secret. Okay. Well, I guess you can eat anything with mayonnaise almost. So that's true. No, that's the potter's wheel. Easy, easy, easy. Calm down, calm down. So we need 4 hemp seeds. I hope we have them. I don't want to go all the way back and... I guess it's not so hard because we can buy some from... Still forget his name. I still call him Linus. Okay, that's barely enough. And next we'll have to go and buy the eggs. Yeah, we can probably do it a little faster. I mean, these are one of the easiest quests you'll have in the game. I mean, go buy eggs. Okay, I'll go and buy eggs. Yeah, what was I saying? Yeah, you can eat anything with mayonnaise. You can eat potatoes, you can eat meat, you can eat barbecue, you can eat some more fancy foods. Also, with mayonnaise, well, you can basically eat even lower quality food and enjoy it. It's like Coca-Cola. Mayonnaise is like Coca-Cola. You can eat almost anything if you have it. So, in that regard, it could be the ultimate flavor enhancer. Well, I guess if you add a little garlic to the mayonnaise, it will be even better. You even eat pizza with mayonnaise, especially garlic one. That spell, it reminds me of something, mysterious food source. Oh no. Oh, it's going to be a very long waiting period for me. Well, like I said, I don't really believe in editing videos, because if you edit the videos, the game will seem something is not. Besides, we don't have anything else to do. I guess you can listen to some music or watch a music video while this turns... The clock spins around. I think this is the reason some people played with cheats in the beginning. If you remember, when the game was released, a lot of people installed a mod, I don't know what it was called, but it basically allowed you to select whatever day you wanted, if I remember correctly, or it just sped up time very, very, very much. Because when the game was released, you didn't have even the stone garden, so you basically had to work a lot and go sleep. If you didn't work, you didn't drain your energy and you couldn't sleep, so yeah. It was a bit of a hassle. It still is a little bit of a hassle right now to kind of pass the time, especially when you have only one mission to work on. Another problem of the game, I'm chewing some gum, is that the game never really got enough combat, in my opinion. You didn't get enough combat, so most of your days you're going to accumulate resources on things that are not going to be useful, like the potions. For example, the only reason to make basically 50% of the potions or a lot of the food types is to do combat, but since that is so limited, I think a lot of people didn't even bother with those. If you got your armor and sword, you are good to go. So yeah, if they ever make a DLC or a second game, I hope it will be 50% combat or At least preparing for the combat. Okay, it's the quake sign. But that's tomorrow. Because a game like this definitely needs more combat or challenges that involve combat or... I don't know, even make turn-based combat, I don't care, just... I just hope it has a lot more combat so you can better prepare yourself, they can introduce new mechanics. The same way for the perks, I mean... You have perks that could help in combat, but there's not enough of it. And also, if you just get a lot of healing items, you don't really need to worry about anything else. Okay, so this is Merchant Day. Also, remember, it's super important that you have the Scene of Shards with you. If you don't have them, it will not work. Okay, dead horse, we meet again. The Halloween decorations are still up. Taste of the sauce. That sounds like you're giving him some strong liquor like whiskey. The market for something, keeper? Not exactly, but I think you like what I'm offering you. You want to sell something to me? How interesting. Exactly, I want to suggest you... Would you be interested in trying a sauce that makes any dish taste even more delicious? Very interesting. What do you ask in return? Nothing. Very suspicious. Tell me what's the catch. Well, nothing. To talk to the person who knows the most about food. Yeah, he actually sells some very good foods. You have come to the right person. If you require nothing in return, give me the sauce. I'll try it with some bread. That was actually a good animation. I like that animation a lot. Gluten charged shard. It's magnificent. What an amazing sauce. Yeah, mayonnaise tastes even good with bread. A deep earthy taste. Some notes of tartrate. So two achievements. Of course, I made it specially for you. I found myself in a more favorable financial... Oh, okay. He doesn't have more money, so he will not give me anything. That's what he basically said. He also has the royal fish dish. He also likes toasts with onions and a lot of other cool things and burgers as well. Also, I really like the royal fish. 84 energy. He also sells the diamonds and some other stuff. Don't really want the grape seeds. Oh, I didn't notice this, but the little... So the little sin shards, when they are charged with the symbol of the character that appears in that specific day. That's a nice touch to the game. Okay, I guess Yurik wants to experience more sin Remula faster. Okay, now I really went again into the wrong door. So what did we get? Pride was the first one. Gluttony and Wrath Shard. Oh, well, let's forget about that. I'll broom up later. What's up? I got two more charge shards. If had been handling things, we'd be going much faster. Really? Oh, maybe you'd rather do everything yourself. Okay, but you have no sense of humor at all. I don't know, everyone tries to make jokes at my expense. Clotto and the merchant and the other people. Sit down and activate the mechanism. This still looks very dangerous. You might shock him or send him to our dimension. Let's go. Okay, you saw that this and this was actually light up. It was... had light in it. I am weak, just as before. Except, you see... I feel somehow empty in my soul. The second therapy session. It's an achievement. Really? He needs a break? Come on, game. We have just begun. Visit him in one day, yeah. I really dislike the fact that they just move around the place like that. Actually, I'll be extra lazy and just teleport over here. Okay, I'll end the video when we know what we have to do for the next quest, because I think that will be a little more surprising, a little harder. So judging from what I can see, I guess this DLC is the easiest one to complete, because you basically need what? You need to talk to some people and get some eggs, get some weird stuff, and get some honey. Well, I guess all this transportation, all of this workaround is kind of bad for you, because you need to go to a lot of places. Okay, graveyard keeper, it's time to actually we'll... But the funny thing is that we're actually helping someone that is not bad. I mean, we helped the other characters as well, but I feel like we did some harm in helping them, or we harmed others in order to help them. This time actually made even the merchant happy, because we gave him mayonnaise. We made the bishop happy, because we wrote him a poem. Well, the inquisitor we made very, very mad, because we told him something really bad. What do you mean, not yet? What about the ghost? Can we bother the ghost? This is annoying. Okay, let's wait until night time then. By the way, I love the game, and I love that they have the Halloween decorations. I think the Halloween decorations remain forever in the game. I've seen some other games that basically activate and deactivate their Halloween events each year, so that's kind of bad. I just wish they would leave them on forever. Okay, let's try now. I hope it doesn't mutate into something really terrible, or I don't know. Also like that the ghost or smiler doesn't talk too much. Oh, where is he now? I'm quite fine today. If you're looking for me, I've gone for a walk in the village. Yurik, apparently he likes to hang out in the tavern. Imagine if you didn't have this stone. You go into the dungeon and then you have to go to the tavern. Okay, he has something to tell me. I sent him to visit Creswald, save the old fool from his loneliness. I expect Yurik will be able to cheer him up. I'd like to ask you something. Is he alright? He seems brooding today. Yes, he's fine. He's just going through a tough time. Healing sins is never easy. The village is certain in shambles. Yeah, it's essential that the village should enjoy better life. When I build them a tavern, that doesn't count. I mean another one. We must stamp out poverty. But I lose all heart when I recall the consequences like the Great Blast. Actually not for long. Did you come for an appointment? I'm not seeing anyone today. Well, not really, because, well, we don't have anything interesting. Are you alright, Eric? You are alright. You visit my place for a warming drink. Thank you, I'll gladly accept. Yes, you're looking for me, I'll be back at my place tomorrow. Hey, I want to sit with you guys too. I mean, I'll not drink, but I'll eat any food you have. You can never have ate you at Creswald. Man, I wanted to eat their food. I mean, a blacksmith must have a lot of good food, because he needs a lot of strength. This is a bit annoying. Why do you have to wait so much? The final shard, but we still have what? 4 more scenes to go? Or maybe well, I guess he's not guilty of all the sins. He might be guilty of only 3 or 4 of them, which makes a little more sense. But then the DLC would be super short. Well, I read on the forums that the final mission for this would be for you to rebuild the village. Or not, maybe not even rebuild, maybe only upgraded or better set. Make the village better. Hello, zombie. No, 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 no. We're going through the right door this time. Okay, over here. Yes, I remembered. I hope he's here now. No, he's not. Where can he be? Looks like this DLC is more about finding Yurik, which is super annoying. By the way, what is my reputation with Creswald? A well-built man with a glorious mustache. Might he be at the tavern again? No, I think he'll just appear at my home. Omelette. Sometimes I like to look at the food he's serving because it all looks delicious. For example, would you like to eat a croissant with some grape pie or I don't know, and then a bowl of sauerkraut? Well, not me. The lentils, pumpkin soup. That sounds very good. A bowl of pumpkin soup. Also, I wish they would animate the kitty. Hey. Dead horse over here. By the way, the horse has two X's on its instead of its eyes like it's dead, so yeah, I don't think a lot of people notice that. So I have two final requests from the developers if they will ever do them. One is to have a calendar that you can select in what day to wake up. And the other one is to animate the kitten. Maybe take the kitty home with you. That's kind of like the only things I want to see in the game. In Graveyard Keeper, because I also want to see Graveyard Keeper 2 with a lot more combat and a lot more interesting places to visit. But just the same complexity in economy, just not as much, you know, running around the place. If he's not here now, I'll have to wait a little bit for the next day and then I'll try again. Also, I wish you could do something else with your zombies, like build an army and send them to fight and they could get resources for you. What? He's not here. Where could he be? Okay, so the first problem was Wagner in the beginning of the DLC. Now it's Yurik. He's not where he's supposed to be. I guess I could check. Okay, we'll check his room, then we'll check the dead horse, and then we'll check Creswald again. Maybe he will tell us something about Yurik. Or maybe I'll just go to the tavern. Yeah, I'll just go to the tavern right now. Let's see, it's daytime. I clicked on Sweet One by accident. Okay, so we'll search for him in his room. So I'm a bit lazy. Cannot pick that one up. Can actually clear a little path. Hello, Smiler. Zero. Oh, he's over here. Just need to wait 2 days instead of one, about the last 3 sins. Wait, I guess they don't care about greed, because that's one they missed. The last 3 sins are ready, we can start searching for the final shard. The final shards, Sloth, Lust and Envy. Well, I'm happy to help you, of course. Well, Sloth is the one I like the most. Sad face, slow feet, sore mood. A struggle, he's always a bit sad. No, he's not, he's melancholic. I know him very well, I know his life story, I know what he did. Astrologer. Not Paul last. Miss Charm, she's a beautiful woman. Yeah. Town from. But you should know her because, wait, this is a plot hole. He comes from the town. He should know Miss Charm because she lives in the town. Of her voice and her feminine charm. Interesting, does she know how to dance? I don't know. She's a good dancer. Introduce her to me and I'll persuade her to join me. I'll be waiting nearby. Okay. Envy. Let me console my book. And it might be the tavern keeper. Oh, okay, so it's Snake. I'll write a small rumor, wait a moment. Here you go, show this to him. Tell him a number of people know about an unknown thief from town. Oh, okay, so we can go to the astrologer today and speak with him, and yeah, this will be a lot of work for the next episode. We'll have to do all three of them at the same time. I mean, that will be fun as well. See you next time. Bye.